Welcome back, this is SvenCortana, aka The Professor, and today we're playing Observation. Now this game has kind of been tickling me a little bit on Xbox. I just haven't had a computer to play it, and this seems like one of those games where you want the computer interface over a console interface. So I'm going to be playing it on my brand new computer. Hopefully this time, I kind of screwed up with my Zoo Tycoon upload. It uploaded in a very poor quality. And I hope that I can fix those problems with this one. But if not, whatever. It's all camera footage anyway, so it looks grainy as fuck. What I do know about this is that you're either playing as the ship's AI or you're controlling the ship's AI. And you're trying to figure out what happened. It's kind of a mystery horror thing. I think it's horror. I'm not 100% sure. But yeah. Let's go ahead and get started. Sure. Okay. It looks very grainy on my screen as well. Like, you can see down the loading thing is it's a lot more clear. And then the middle part is just grainy, I guess, because of the footage type look to it. And my drink of choice tonight is Diet Dr. Pepper. Also, I'm thinking about including a webcam here shortly for my streaming and YouTube videos, so hit me up, see if you like that idea or not. It's just static I hear right now. Low orbit space station observation. 410 km above Earth. Kilometers. Well, that's not good. Sam the AI. Ooh. Okay.
Come on, give me something. Sam, are you there? Respond.
I am here.
I'm going to relocate you to the Horizon Utility Hub in Module 9. That should give you access to limited system diagnostics.
This is kind of weird.
Listen, I'm stuck in the Horizon airlock in Module 11. I need to get into 9, but I'm not sure if it's safe to open this hatch door. Can you give me hull and pressure diagnostics on Module 9?
Thank you.
Module 9 is fully pressurized.
Okay, that's good. Good. Are the adjacent contact points from 9 intact?
Module 9 hull contact points to adjacent modules read true.
Good. We're still connected.
Okay.
Something is vibrating, Sam. Can you check the hull contact points on the other modules?
Sure.
Module 8. Hull contact points to adjacent modules read true.
Okay. Well, at least I can maybe get down to central through there. What about module 10?
Module 10. Hull contact points to 12 read false. Suggesting that module 12 is no longer securely attached to the station.
Okay.
Sam, the hatch door is jammed shut. The controls aren't responding. See if you can restore power. Sam, are you still there?
Oh, this is creepy as shit. Oh, Lord. Lord, Lord, Lord. She dead? Hello? She dead as fuck. What the fuck just happened? Oh, this is gonna be a scary game. Oh, shit. Oh, no, she's not dead. She's just sleepy. One of these things moves, I'm gonna shit myself. There you go, you're good.
What just happened?
I don't know.
I think I blacked out.
Oh, there's an epilepsy warning for this game. I guess because of the shaky screen that's going on right now.
Sam, run your self-diagnostic procedure. And what errors are you showing?
Relocation functions are offline. I require auto routing to access module cameras.
Okay, I can manually relocate you, but once I get out of here, I'll get your systems up and running.
We're not doing good on memory core.
The main memory core has been corrupted. I have lost significant station data.
Okay. So most of your system links and data logs are gone. Sam, you will need to scan, download, and recover as much data as you can. We need to get you back to your old self.
Okay.
Connection between crew tracker functionality and SAM OS has been severed.
So it's working, but the link is cut. I'll need to reconnect it in Central. Josh? May? Anyone? Shit. Okay. Yeah. I can't get out of here. The hatch controls aren't working. It might be a safety lockdown. You'll have to override the hatch from Module 9. Okay. I'm auto-routing you back to the utility hub in Module 9. Camera movement should be online now. Run a test. Looks good. Camera cycling should be active as well. Check the other cameras. Great. I can see your live feed updating from here. There should be a system links reset procedure document on the wall somewhere in there. Find it and scan it. Your scan range is limited, so use your camera zoom to get closer.
Alright, system link reset, blah 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 blah. Okay.
Okay. That should be reinstalling the system link interface. Use your cameras to locate the hatch controls and any other integrated systems and equipment. Your system link interface to open the EAS 11 airlock. That's it. It's open. I'm out. Good work, Sam.
Yay, I figured things out. Okay. I'm sorry if I'm being quiet. I'm just trying to, like, take in what's going on. Because I assume at some point I'm going to be a lot faster at this.
Josh? I don't know if you can hear me, but...
Oh, I hate these
things. Oh, she's kind of hot. She got some teeth on her. Her mouth's doing weird things too.
Josh, if you're in EAS module 12, then stay put. The hull connection isn't secure, and most of our systems are underpowered. I'll work something out.
It's her eyes. I like Josh. Her eyes. They're not exceptionally well rendered, but it's pretty. I did really good with the face on her.
What? Wait a minute, Sam. Our internal communication network is fully online. Where has everyone gone?
They probably all dead.
Shit. You should have access to your OS now.
You can now relocate to any module and view its camera feeds. In the EAS arm, at least. Try it now. Find that fire, Sam.
Thank you.
Please repeat your previous request.
The alarm is showing a fire. Find the fire and tell me where it is, Sam.
There is a fire out of control in EAS 4.
Shit, I'm on my way.
Like you already have the hatch system links. Good. Get ready. Fire suppression override. Dr. Emma Fisher. Okay, Sam. I need you to get ready and open the door.
On three. Are you ready? One. Two.
You need to fucking calm your ass down. Jesus. Trying to find the fucking door.
Sam. Get the vents on in here. Clear these fumes. That's it, it's working. The fumes are dissipating now. How bad is it?
The rack units have been damaged beyond any functional use.
Overall, that's not too bad, considering. What started it? What was the source, Sam? We need to stop it happening again.
Residue on panel LFE1 indicates a potential source.
What? That's just a blank plate. Let me see. Something is coming out of the side. What is that?
Ew.
Grease or oil. Dark red. There's maybe something in storage above that's leaking. Oh, come on. What now? Sam, give me a
significant stress being applied to EAS 12. Immediate separation recommended.
Please, if there is anyone in Module 12, make yourself known now. We are about to jettison the module. Someone, please respond. This is getting much worse. Okay. Sam, get ready for the separation procedure.
Okay, first, process my authorization code and give me a security override key. 14424133324.
Fuck.
Shit. The module has torn off. Airlock is holding. God. Who knows what damage that's done?
Whoops.
What happened back there, Sam?
Well, you see, the controls are really dumb. That was really dumb.
The CN arm is badly damaged.
Oh God, May. It looks intact, though.
There is minor exterior damage to module EAS-4, likely due to the internal fire.
Yeah, I think we got lucky there.
solar panel array on the EAS arm has been torn off.
That explains the lack of power. I'm going to connect to the distance cam. We should see where we are above Earth and if we've lost any altitude.
Ooh, that's not Earth.
How did we get here?
I brought you here. It seems.
What? Why?
Well, that is very interesting. So yeah, I think I'm going to cut this episode off right here. That was a really intense opening. I hope that me fucking up that one thing doesn't have any negative effect later on. Anyways, make some little like button, leave us a call, babies, and that's a good channel, because it really does help out. And we will see you guys next time.